Oh my goodness, Rhea Perlman, it is such a pleasure to have the opportunity to talk to you. How are you today?
Why, thank you. I'm great. I mean, it's early in the morning here in LA, but I feel pretty energized right now. Yay!
Well, I'm glad to hear that. I'm talking to you from Toronto, so it's a little bit later in the morning. So I do appreciate it. Rhea, to say that you are amazing in this film is an understatement. I loved your character. I love that you took it on. It was pretty bold and brave of you because you had a lot of things to do that you've never done before. So when you got the script, when you were approached, like, what was going through your head?
Well, I just assumed someone else would be doing the magic. I play a magician and I just figured it's a movie. They're going to use somebody's hands who knows what they're doing.
Right.
But, you know, but I loved what was going through my mind first was that I loved the script. I loved it. I didn't know the director ahead of time, but somebody had recommended that I read it, you know, who did know her. And I just thought, what a cool project this is, you know. So, and then she told me I'd have to do the magic myself. And
so and what did you do? Like, did you run out to like magic shows and start watching people? Tell me a little bit about
that
process.
You know what I did? She provided me with an amazing tutor. A woman magician named Kayla Drescher, who's just, you know, brilliant. I mean, she's a magician that performs at the Magic Castle here, which is, I don't know if you guys know what that is.
Oh,
you know,
we do. Yeah, we absolutely. I've been there. Yeah.
And she's great. And she was so patient with me. And I recorded her, you know, doing so I could just do it over and over and over. But she would come two or three times a week. I had about three or four weeks to prepare. And even then it was like, I don't think I can do this, Kayla. I really don't think I can do it. But, you know, we did it.
Yeah. And it's funny because I truly love watching magic shows. I just find them so fascinating and how they do it and the sleight of hand and all that kind of stuff. Was there a trick that you were particularly really looking forward to learning or just, you know, you really surprised yourself when you pulled it off?
You know, the fact that I could palm the card without people seeing through my fingers, I can't even tell you how simple that trick is. And you see in the movie, even Mia, who plays the lead, the 13-year-old girl, you know, who's I'm mentoring, she does it like that. I mean, it was like, you learned that. It wasn't even like your job in the movie to know that. And it was just amazing. So, every trick was difficult.
I'm sure. Well, you pulled it off. You fooled me. So, if you want to, you know, if this acting thing doesn't work out for you, Rhea, maybe you want to become a magician. I'll come to your show.
I will invite you. You will be alone, but I will invite you.
I appreciate it. You can go on tour. Come to Toronto. I got this all planned for you. Okay, speaking of Mia, we got to talk about her because, first of all, I truly love the relationship between Margot and Sammy, the two characters. I love it when a young person bonds with somebody who's older. It just touches me so much. I love seeing that. And you don't see a lot of that in movies and TV, like, you know. Uh-huh. When you started to work with her, what surprised you or really impressed you about her? She's fantastic in this film.
Well, she's the most professional young actress I've ever worked with. But not in a weird way. You know, she's just there. Yeah. She's there. She knows she's got it all together before she comes to set. She knows her lines. She knows what she's doing. She's got her emotions like right at the tip of her fingers. Wow. And which that impresses the hell out of me if anyone can do that, because sometimes that's really hard for me. But and she just is also a sweet person. She's just a sweet person and to know. So, you know, she kind of has it all. I know she's going to be a big star or a director if she wants to be. She's smart as hell. And I love her. I just love her.
Yeah, because, you know, look, over your career, of course, you've worked with young kids. Like, I mean, you look back on Matilda and, you know, and she was just amazing, a powerhouse.
She was amazing too. I should not say. Yeah.
So what do you think it is, just from your experience? I know that I've interviewed so many young kids before, and especially, you know, if they're you know when they're grounded because they have good parents, they have good people behind them. What do you think is the trick about keeping these young actors grounded when they're young, and that when they get older, they keep that, you know, they don't get full of themselves?
Well, I think family is big. You know, you said that family and friends, and that you're not taken away by the business, you know, that and being grounded when you're young is really about your connections to other people in general. So if you can connect with your parents, with your siblings, with your good friends, you know, it carries over. I know it's for my kids who, you know, I have one kid who's an actor, but was not a child actor. But
right,
you know, my kids have always been pretty grounded, I think, because that we really tried to instill love and, you know, respect in their lives.
Yeah, it's the most important thing, especially when, yeah, exactly, you and your husband, or I mean, well, you know, you and Danny, I mean, of course, huge, huge stars. So it's got to be tough for kids growing up in a family like that to kind of like, you know, and for you to keep them like, hey guys, you know, like, you're not just so privileged. It's got to be a hard balance, I would think.
Yeah. And they have it. I feel like they, you know, they, of course, we were in LA and, you know, you got all the people that they know who were, that had, they also had some money and they could buy whatever they want, and they did.
Yeah.
But my kids, even though really Danny and I would give them anything, they weren't like that. They came to their own conclusions one after the other that wasn't where it was at for them.
Yeah. That's, you know, great. That's really, really great. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good to know. I know. I always instill that in my boys too. Like, I'm there for you, but you got to work hard for, you know, and not good. Thank God they came out okay. So
I'm so glad.
Yeah. You know, Rita, I have a few minutes left, and I can't not talk to you and not mention Cheers, because of course it was the show that I never, ever missed every single week. Like, I just so look forward to it. And it was the best. And, you know, and I wondered, like, when you look back on that and the friendships that you made, the people that you worked with, when you look at some of them, like somebody like a Woody Harrelson who started on that show, and look at him now, you know,
I know.
It's truly amazing. You keep in touch with everybody, and it had to have been a family when you left. I can't imagine that you don't still talk to Ted Danson and the rest of the gang.
We do keep in touch, but not in a constant way. But there's always going to be that, you know, that phone call, that conversation, that, you know, maybe we should take a walk together. You know, with Ted, with George Wendt, and with Kirstie, and even Woody, who, you know, love those guys. Oh, sorry.
It's okay. No worries.
You know, my clock is telling me to wake up now. Okay. All right.
I appreciate you getting up before your alarm is set for me.
Yeah.
I really appreciate that. But it's amazing, because, you know, I think you need to call Ted Danson and say, I need a cameo on Mr. Mayor.
Yeah. Well, okay. Maybe you should call for me.
That for you. I will do that for you.
Right.
And I also can't leave, because I, you know, being the Canadian girl in me, you of course were in Canadian Bacon, and you work with the great John Candy. Any amazing memories that stand out for you working on that film?
John Candy is like, you know what I mean, what he was, you know, we bonded immediately, because he did this big bear, and he was just like, yeah, come, we'll go hang out, and just, you know, let's have a beer. And just such an easy, wonderful, funny man who dealt with a lot of issues of his own. And and I was there, I don't know, we got very close very quickly. I would help him out when he needed help. And, you know, when he passed away, which was so soon after that.
That was his last film, I believe.
I think he might have been, was he in the middle of making another one?
I think so, if I recall. Yeah. But I know that was the last one. Yeah. I can't, you know, a privilege for you to be able to work with some of the people that you've worked with.
So many. I mean, well, of course, everyone from my show, everyone from Taxi.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Of course.
That, you know, so many. And I'll tell you, Kate Tsang, the director of this movie, Marvelous in the Black Hole. She, and it's her first feature.
I know, right?
She's done shorts. She's an artist, and she's a writer, and she's just brilliant. And talk about grounded and having it together. She's got, I mean, wow. You know, you don't meet many directors who you come in and they're really still making their mind up about what shot to do. You know, she's great.
Well, you're great. And, you know, it's a great title for the film because the film is marvelous. It's really, really good.
I get to wear that cape that says marvelous. That
and did you keep it? Thing. Did you get to keep it?
I didn't get to keep it, but I got to keep the shoes, the boots.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Do you remember that they're painted?
Yes.
They're my actual boots. And this amazing costume designer painted them.
Wow.
With these flowers. And I was like, yeah. We had some talented people on that movie.
Well, it's a gem. It really, really is. And I hope we're going to see in more stuff. Do you have more things coming out?
I don't know if they're not coming out, but I have two projects. Well, they will be coming out. I got one that will come out in the end of the summer called 13 the Musical.
No kidding.
By the way.
Wow. Yeah.
And I'm going to London to do a project and then back to Toronto to do a project. So
we need to hook up for a coffee. We gotta do that. Absolutely.
Okay.
I would love to treat you to a nice coffee downtown now that people are actually sitting together and you know and
I know because when I was there doing that other movie besides the 2-week quarantine in the hotel, which was hell, it was nothing was open.
Yeah.
Not until the last few days that I was there.
Well, things are opening up again, thank goodness. And if you're here over the summer, then for sure we can just sit at a patio. So it's all good.
I love it.
Okay. Maria, thank you. Thank you so much for your time. You're a delight and take care. Take travels and everything. Okay.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye.
Okay. Bye.